will go through hardships. Every single person will have bumps in their life. There's no one that can claim he or she does not have any problems in life. Male or female, young or old, Muslim or non-Muslim. Every single person will have some sort of problem in life. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, in an authentic narration, one day he drew a square, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and he drew a line in the middle, which was coming outside of the square. And he drew small lines on the sides of this line in the middle. And he said, this is the lifespan of a human, of a person. And this line in the middle is his wishes and desires. And the line that is, this line in the middle that is going outside of this box, that is his wishes and desires, which will never be fulfilled. And the inner lines next to the small lines, next to the line going up, he said, these are his problems that he's going to face in life. If this one misses him, this one is going to tackle him. If this one misses him, this one is going to catch him. So the Prophet ﷺ made it clear to us that every person in this world will go through some sort of problem. No one will have such a smooth life that there will be no bumps in their lives. It is almost impossible. You can wait for that in Jannah. But in this dunya, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not promise anyone happiness. Eternal happiness you will not have in this world, in this dunya. But the amazing part is when a believer, he goes through any sort of hardships, it is different. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He rewards him for that. It is a means for him to get closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And if he is closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala elevates his status. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, عَجَبًا لِأَمْرِ الْمُؤْمِنِ. It is very amazing. All situations of a believer, it's amazing. فَإِنَّ أَمْرَهُ كُلَّهُ لَهُ خَيْرٍ. Indeed, every situation of a believer, there is goodness in it. وَلَيْسَ ذَٰلِكَ لِأَحَدٍ إِلَّا لِمُؤْمِنٍ. And this is not for anyone except a believer. Only a believer gets this. Every situation of his life, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has placed blessing and barakah and goodness in it. فَإِنْ أَصَابَتْهُ سَرَّاءٌ شَكَرٌ فَكَانَتْ خَيْرًا لَهُ. If anything good happens to him, then he is thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and that is better for him. وَإِنْ أَصَابَتْهُ ضَرَّاءٌ صَبَرٌ فَكَانَتْ خَيْرًا لَهُ. Anything bad happens to him, anything that happens to him that he dislikes or hurts him, he is patient, and he remembers Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he is patient, that is better for him. Our teacher used to say that there is two things you need in life. If you have these two things in your life, you will always be happy. Shukr and sabr. To be thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to be grateful to Him, and to be patient. Imagine if we all had to be grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for whatever He has given us, then we would never complain. And when hardships comes upon us, we are patient, we know it is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then also we would never complain. We would have a peaceful life. We would have peace of mind. Everyone would be happy. No one would be jealous of each other. No one would try to run each other down if we had these two things in life. Shukr, being thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for whatever He has given us, and to be patient. There's a beautiful narration narrated by Al-Qamah radiallahu anhu. Imam Hakim in his Mustadrak narrates, he says, there was a group that came to the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and it was seven of us. I was the seventh of them, meaning this happened with my group, that I came, I was in that group, We went to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, فَسَلَّمْنَا. We gave him salam, فَرَدَّ عَلَيْنَا السَّلَام. He returned our salam, فَكَلَّمْنَا. We spoke with him, فَأَعْجَبَهُ كَلَامُنَا. Our speech made him very happy and amazed. So the Prophet of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, مَا أَنْتُمْ. Who are you people? You people are so well-mannered, and the way you spoke, you know, it is very amazing, and I'm very happy with you. Who are you people? They said, قُلْنَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ. We are the believers. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, لِكُلِّ قَوْلٍ حَقِيقَةٍ. Every statement has a reality. فَمَا حَقِيقَةُ إِيمَانِكُمْ. So, what is the reality of your iman? You're saying that you're a believer. Prove it to me. What's your dalil? What's your proof? They said, we have 15 qualities within us. خَمْسٌ أَمَرْتَنَا بِهَا وَخَمْسٌ أَمَرَتْنَا بِهَا رُسُلُكْ وَخَمْسٌ تَخَلَّقْنَا بِهَا فِي الْجَاهِلِيَّةِ. We have 15 qualities that we possess. 5, you have commanded us with. And 5, your messenger that you sent to us to teach us Islam, he told us to practice these 5. And 5 qualities that we have, we were created with those 5 qualities even before Islam. And even till now, we are practicing those 5 qualities that we possessed before Islam. إِلَّا أَن تَنْهَانَا يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ. Unless you tell us to leave them, O Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. If you tell us to leave these qualities, we will leave them. But you asked, what makes us believers? We are giving you the answer. These 15 qualities that we possess. The first 10 is very easy. Simple. First 5 was the 5 pillars of Islam. Second 5, the Messenger told us to, you know, have conviction in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, iman in Allah, and the messengers and the books and the angels, and to believe in qadr, whether good or bad. It's very simple. Alhamdulillah, we all have it. And the 5 qualities, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked them, so what are the 5 qualities that you were created with before Islam, before accepting Islam? They said, number 1, الشكر عند الرخاء. We were always thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or the Creator, or whoever the Lord was. We were always thankful when we had easy times. الشكر عند الرخاء. When things were easy, we're thankful and grateful. Number 1 quality they had before Islam. Number 2, وَالصَّبْرُ عِنْدَ الْبَلَاءِ. We were patient. We were patient when we had difficult condition upon us. When we had difficult times, we were patient. And this was before Islam. Number 3, وَالصِّدْقُ فِي مَوَاطِنِ اللِّقَاءِ. When we met our enemies, we were true. Meaning, we were never scared of anyone. We were people that had bravery. We were brave people and steadfast and strong people. Number 4, they said, وَالرَّضَى بِمُرِّ الْقَضَى. And we were always happy with the decisions of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, even though it went against our own desires. Even though it was bitter for us to accept it, but we accepted the decree of Allah and we were pleased with it. Whatever was our decree, we were happy with it. Number 5, amazing. وَتَرْكُ الشَّمَاتَةِ بِالْمُصِيبَةِ إِذَا حَلَّتْ بِالْأَعْدَاءِ. And when our enemies, when they face any calamity, we weren't joyful about that. We weren't happy even when our enemies face any calamity. We cannot see anyone, or we cannot stand anyone going through hardships. Even it can be our enemy, our own enemy, but if they go through a hard time, we will feel bad for them and we will help them. These were the 5 qualities that they possessed before Islam. Now think to ourselves, me and you, do we possess these qualities? We recite the Qur'an every day. We come to the masjid every day. We're making nawafil, giving sadaqah and zakah, fasting, making hajj, going for umrah. So many good deeds. But do we possess these qualities? It is very important for us to have these qualities within us, being Muslims. The Prophet wasallam, he was so happy with their answer. He said, "Fuqaha udaba kadu an yakunu anbiya min khisal ma ashrafah Allah." He said, "Fuqaha, intellectuals, smart people, very understanding people, udaba, well-mannered people, well-cultured people, amazing people you are. Kadu an yakunu anbiya." It was very close that you became like prophets because of these high qualities that you possess. وَتَبَسَّمَ إِلَيْنَا. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he looked at all of us and he smiled and he was so happy with us. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, "I will add on to 5 more qualities to you so that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala could complete all good qualities within you." So my point here is that when we go through hard times, remember, it is normal. When we go through a difficult condition, it is normal. It is the system of this world. This is how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala kept it. Do not lose hope. لَا تَيْأَسُوا مِنْ رَوْحِ اللَّهِ. The father of Yusuf alayhi salam, he told his sons, first Yusuf alayhi salam was lost. And then Binyamin, the younger child, he was lost. And the older sons, they said, "Oh, our father, you know, you became mental. You still cry over Yusuf, it's been so many years. Yusuf is not going to come back, he's gone." The father would say, "La ta'asu min rahillah. Go search for both of them. Yusuf, that was lost over 10 years ago. And Binyamin, that was lost."
The volume is not going up. We are not hearing.
Binyamin, that was lost. Go search for both of them. لا تيأسوا من روح الله. Do not lose hope in the mercy of Allah. فإنه لا ييأسوا من روح الله إلا القوم الكافرون. Because the only people that lose hope in the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala are the disbelievers and the people that reject. So no matter whichever problems you're facing, remember, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one that put you through that test, and He's the only one that can save you. When we go through problems, it does not mean that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't like us. It does not mean He's angry with us all the time. No. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the reason we go through hardships, hard conditions at times, is that we can get closer to Him. If you are close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He wants to elevate our status. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, أَشَدُّ النَّاسِ إِبْتِلَاءً الْأَنْبِيَاءِ ثُمَّ الصَّالِحُونَ ثُمَّ الصَّالِحُونَ. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, people that suffered the most hardships are the Prophets. And remember, the Prophets are the most beloved people to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But they went and they suffered through the most hardships. And then the righteous after them. And then people that follow them in righteousness. So it is normal to go through hard conditions. Remember again, it is not because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not like you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us, when we go through hard times, what should we do? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اسْتَعِينُوا بِالصَّبْرِ وَالصَّلَاةِ إِنَّ اللَّهُ مَعَ الصَّابِرِينَ. That, O you who believe, seek help from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with patience and with salah. Indeed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is with those that are patient. He will definitely help them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He puts us through different tests to see how strong we are, to see how faithful we are. When we're going through any hard condition, Do we leave Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Do we leave His worship? Do we forget Him? Or we get closer to Him? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants to see how truthful and how faithful we are to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And remember, the believers, when they are faced with any calamity, their attention goes towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala right away. And when that calamity is removed, they get even closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala even more. On the other hand, the hypocrites and the disbelievers, when they're faced through any situation, for some time, they're gonna, you know, call Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala removes that calamity, they'll go back to their old ways. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, أَلَمْ تَرَ أَنَّ الْفُلْكَ تَجْرِي فِي الْبَحْرِ بِنِعْمَةِ اللَّهِ لِيُرِيَكُمْ مِنْ آيَاتِهِ إِنَّ فِي ذَلِكَ لَآيَاتٍ لِكُلِّ صَبَّارٍ شَكُورٍ. Don't you see how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made the ships flow in the ocean like mountains? Indeed, in it, in this sign of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, إِنَّ فِي ذَلِكَ in this, إِنَّ فِي ذَلِكَ لَآيَاتٍ, there is great signs, لِكُلِّ صَبَّارٍ, for every person that is very patient, and every person that is thankful. These two things, patience and gratefulness. فَإِذَا غَشِيَهُمْ مَوْجٌ كَالظُّلَلِ دَعَوُ اللَّهِ مُخْلِصِينَ لَهُ الدِّينَ. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, they're going in their boat nicely and peacefully. Then when the waves cover it, when the waves cover this ship and this boat, then what happens? دَعَوُ اللَّهَ مُخْلِصِينَ لَهُ الدِّينَ. Then they call to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They call upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with complete devotion and sincerity. You know, there's a very famous saying that there's no atheist on a sinking ship or sinking boat. At that time, no matter what you believe in, you're gonna, oh my God, that's the first thing that's gonna come to your mind or come on your tongue. You know, oh Allah, protect me, save me, save me. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, when people or the rejectors or the people that do not worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when they face any difficulty, any calamity, at once they'll come back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with complete devotion. فَلَمَّا نَجَّاهُمْ إِلَى الْبَرِّ فَمِنْهُمْ مُقْتَصِدْ. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protects them and saves them, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when He takes them to the land, then from amongst them, there are those that will go back to their own ways, and they will be ungrateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So when we go through hardships, remember, it is because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants us to get closer to Him. When the companions radiallahu anhum, the anbiya, prophets alayhimu salam, when they faced any difficulty, they knew it is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to elevate their status, so they were patient. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us so many examples throughout the Quran. Yunus alayhi salam, Yusuf alayhi salam, Ayyub alayhi salam, Yaqub alayhi salam, how they were patient. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, how he was patient. Remember, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He can test us, and He will test us, and everyone's test is different. Some people will be tested through wealth, some people through status, some people through children, some people through family members, some people through women, some people through men. You know, so many different challenges that we have in life. But when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sees that you pass the test, you will see how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will open His doors and His rahmah and His blessings to you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says in the Quran, وَالَّذِينَ جَاهَدُوا فِينَا لَنَهْدِيَنَّهُمْ سُبُلَنَا. Indeed, those that strive in our cause, لَنَهْدِيَنَّهُمْ سُبُلَنَا. Indeed, definitely, we will guide them. We will guide them in many different paths, many different ways, not one way. Sabil is one, subul is plural. Many different ways will open up for them, many different doors and avenues will open up for them. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the understanding. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the tawfiq to be steadfast on his deen. أَقُولُ قَوْلِ هَذَا وَأَسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهَ لِي وَلَكُمْ وَلِسَائِرِ الْمُسْلِمِينَ فَاسْتَغْفِرُوهُ إِنَّهُ هُوَ الْغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ. إن الحمد لله الصلاة والسلام على رسول الله أما بعد. So throughout the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us different examples so that we can take a lesson from it. You know, when we go through hard times, you know, we should remember it is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We shouldn't go into depression and then we want to do this and that and commit suicide. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us. Ameen. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He narrates to us the stories and the incidents of different prophets. Why? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, لَقَدْ كَانَ فِي قَصَصِهِمْ عِبْرَةٌ لِأُولِي الْأَلْبَابِ. Indeed, in their stories, in their incidents, there is lessons for people of intelligence, people of intellect. For them, there is great lessons in these stories and incidents. مَا كَانَ حَدِيثًا يُفْتَرَى. These are not made up stories. وَلَكِنْ تَصْدِيقَ الَّذِي بَيْنَ يَدَيْهِ وَتَفْصِيلَ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ وَهُدًى وَرَحْمَةً لِقَوْمٍ يُؤْمِنُونَ. Indeed, it is the truth from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So these examples and stories that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us in the Quran is so that we can live by it, so that we can take a lesson from it, so that when we face the same problems or similar problems, we will act like the Anbiya, Prophets alayhi salam acted, so that we can act the way the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam acted, so that we can act the way the companions acted when they faced any calamity. One of the great incident is regarding Ayyub alayhi salam. We know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says, Inna wajadnahu sabira. Indeed, we found Ayyub alayhi salam to be very patient. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala didn't say Ayyub was patient. He said, we found patience in Ayyub. We found patience in Ayyub, as if even patience was shy of Ayyub alayhi salam's patience. That's how patient Ayyub alayhi salam was. And if we open the Quran, Surah Al-Anbiya, Surah Sad, right? So many places in the Quran, so many prophets, examples Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us, so that we can learn from it and live by it. Because the Quran was sent to us as what? ذَلِكَ الْكِتَابُ لَا رَيْبَ فِيهِ هُدًى لِلْمُتَّقِينَ. The Quran was sent to us as guidance, so that we can live by it. إِنَّ هَذَا الْقُرْآنَ يَهْدِي لِلَّتِي هِيَ أَقْوَمُ. This Quran is guidance for us. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah Al-Anbiya, He mentions the incident of Ayyub alayhi salam also in Surah Al-Sad. He says, وَأَيُّوبَ إِذْ نَادَى رَبَّهُ أَنِّي مَسَّنِيَ الضُّرُّ وَأَنْتَ أَرْحَمُ الرَّاحِمِينَ. When Ayyub alayhi salam, He called upon us that indeed difficulty has befallen me. وَأَنْتَ أَرْحَمُ الرَّاحِمِينَ. And you are the most merciful. The incident of Ayyub alayhi salam is that Ayyub alayhi salam was a well-respected man, the most beloved person in town. And he was a prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made him very rich. He was a very wealthy man. He was the wealthiest man in town. Ayyub alayhi salam was married, according to the Kathir, to the granddaughter of Yusuf alayhi salam. Layya, her name was. May Allah be pleased with her. And Ayyub alayhi salam was blessed with 14 children. Ibn Kathir mentions Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him 14 children. 7 boys and 7 daughters. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted to test Ayyub alayhi salam. First thing that happened is he lost his wealth. Everything he had. He became very poor. And you know, when we have wealth, we can't really tell, you know, our true friends who they are. Because it's not, they don't love you, they love the wealth. Same thing happened here. The most beloved person, now slowly people started leaving Ayyub alayhi salam. And now, after he lost all of his wealth, Ayyub alayhi salam lost his children also, one by one. All 14. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave Ayyub alayhi salam a disease. Mufassirin explained something similar to leprosy, where his skin would fall off. And people became really, distant from him, and they were disgusted by Ayyub alayhi salam. So what people did, they forced Ayyub alayhi salam to leave town. They threw him outside of the town. And he lived in this condition, according to different mufassirin, different years they give, about 18 years Ayyub alayhi salam lived in this condition. Imagine. No money, no children, bad health. For 18 years, he couldn't do anything on his own. To such an extent, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran regarding his wife, that وَخُذْ بِيَدِكَ ضِغْطًا فَضْرِبْ بِهِ وَلَا تَحْنَثْ. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about him hitting his wife in the Quran, it doesn't mean beating his wife. According to Imam Ahmad bin Hanbal in his Musnad, he brings one narration. He says that Ayyub alayhi salam, when he fell sick, Shaytan came to his wife in the form of a physician, as a doctor. And he told his wife, I want to cure your husband, free of charge. On one condition, that when he's cured, you will tell him that you cured him. You cured Ayyub alayhi salam. Now of course, she's the granddaughter of Yusuf alayhi salam, a wife of a prophet also. Now, she's thinking something is not right. She goes, tells Ayyub alayhi salam the incident. Ayyub alayhi salam, he said, he got really upset. He says, this is shirk. This is shirk. How could you cure? And how could he cure? Cure comes from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He said that was shaitan. And Ayyub alayhi salam, he said, how could you even think of this? He said, if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives me good health, then I will lash you 100 times. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when Ayyub alayhi salam got cured, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told him, فَخُذْ بِيَدِكَ ضِغْطًا فَضْرِبْ بِهِ وَلَا تَحْنَثْ, that grab 100 twigs, and tap your wife with it once, and do not break your promise. Meaning she was not hurt, and he didn't beat his wife, and he also fulfilled his promise, or the oath that he took. So Ayyub alayhi salam, his wife used to go see to his needs outside of the town. And once Ayyub alayhi salam was there, and his wife said, why don't you make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to cure you? Imagine, not for 1 year, 2 years, 3 years, for 18 years he lived in this condition. You can find all of this in Ibn Kathir, you can read it. His wife said, why don't you, ask for cure? Ayyub alayhi salam said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he has blessed me with good health and everything that a person could ever ask for 70 years. For 70 years. For these few years, I'm not going to complain. For these few years, I'm not going to complain. Remember, these incidents, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us so that we can take a lesson from it. Who's going through a harder time than Ayyub alayhi salam here? I believe no one, including myself. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us so much ease compared to these prophets. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us these incidents so that he can make our hearts firm on his deen. So Ayyub alayhi salam said, no, this is impossible. And then there was a time when Ayyub alayhi salam, he made dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala after some time. So Allah, I'm not complaining to you. I'm not complaining to you. I'm just letting you know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَذْكُرْ عَبْدَنَا أَيُّوبُ إِذْ نَادَى رَبَّهُ أَنِّي مَسَّنِيَ الشَّيْطَانُ بِنُصْبٍ وَعَذَابٍ. Oh Allah, indeed shaitan has caused great difficulty and pain upon me. And the muhaddithin, they explain, the mufassirin, they explain what this pain was. This pain is Ayyub alayhi salam, when he was ill, shaitan would come to Ayyub alayhi salam. And the shaitan would try to whisper things in his heart, that you're ill for so many years and Allah left you alone like this. Ayyub alayhi salam says, oh Allah, this is causing me a greater pain than my physical pain. Shaitan whispering this to me, that you're still not cured. For so long you're in this condition. This caused me even more pain. This is how connected Ayyub alayhi salam was with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah says, Ayyub alayhi salam, he says about him, he was awwab. His heart was connected and always linked with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and his worship. When Jibreel alayhi salam would come down to Ayyub alayhi salam and ask him, you know, how are you? The only thing he would say is what? Alhamdulillah. I'm pleased with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. All praise belong to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This was the patience of Ayyub alayhi salam. When Ayyub alayhi salam, he passed the test, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, Urkud birijlik. Now Ayyub, hit the ground that you're in with your heels. هَذَا مُغْتَسَلٌ بَالِدٌ وَشَرَابٌ. You'll find a cool spring gushing out. And, you know, wash yourself with it and drink from it. So Ayyub alayhi salam did that. Right away, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he made Ayyub alayhi salam young again. He was cured from his disease instantly. So his wife, she was outside, when she came to see Ayyub alayhi salam outside of the town, and she sees a person near, Ayyub alayhi salam was left near a dumpster, people left him, but he doesn't see Ayyub alayhi salam there anymore, and he sees a person nearby. He says, did you see my husband? Did you see this person that was laying down there near the dumpster? He says, no. Who are you looking for? You're looking for Ayyub. She says, and he says, I'm Ayyub. Subhanallah. She says, you're making fun of me. I lost my husband. I'm crying here. And then you're taking, you know, you're making fun of me. Then he says, focus. And he narrated the incident that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told him to hit the ground with his heels. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala cured him. And of course, and then she realized it was Ayyub alayhi salam. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَوَهَبْنَا لَهُ أَهْلَهُ وَمِثْلَهُمْ مَعَهُمْ رَحْمَةً مِنَّا وَذِكْرًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, we gave Ayyub alayhi salam everything he had, we gave it back to him. All the wealth he had, we gave it back to him. 14 children he had, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave it back, meaning he had 14 more children at that age. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَمِثْلَهُمْ. We doubled it. Now he had double of the wealth. And he had 28 children. This was when Ayyub alayhi salam was steadfast and he passed the exam of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us tawfiq. We should always ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for afiyah. Allahumma inna nas'aluka al-afwa wal-afiyah. Oh Allah, we ask for ease. Make things easy for us. But when things do become hard for us, do not lose hope in the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Always hold on to the rope of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Inna Allah wa malaikatahu yusalluna 'ala an-nabi. Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu sallu 'alayhi wa sallimu taslima. Allahumma salli 'ala Muhammad wa 'ala ali Muhammad. كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم وارض عن خلفائه الراشدين المهديين أبي بكر وعمر وعثمان وعلي، وارض عنا معهم بمنك وكرمك ورحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين وأذل الشرك والمشركين. اللهم دمر أعداءك أعداء الدين. اللهم اغفر لنا وللمؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات الأحياء منهم والأموات. اللهم ألف بين قلوب المسلمين وأصلح ذات بينهم وانصرهم على عدوك وعدوهم. سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين.